Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how to explode a graphic in Apple Motion. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So recently I redesigned that intro there for the show. One of the ideas I had was to have the MacMost logo kind of come together from a bunch of particles, like a reverse explosion. I built that in Motion and I didn't quite like the effect for my show, but it is a really cool effect, so I'll show you how to build it. So if you're not familiar with Motion, it is an app from Apple. It only costs $50 and it's basically a companion to Final Cut Pro that allows you to create motion graphics. In other words, it's Apple's version of Adobe After Effects. I'm using version 5.4.3, the most recent one. And we're going to start off by creating a motion project. So the first thing we want to do is we want to get the graphic in here. I'm going to shrink the view area here so I can see the entire thing. And I'm going to drag and drop the MacMost logo in here. I'm going to lock it to the center using those guidelines there. And I'm going to shrink it a bit since I don't want it to be so big. So I'm going to hold the Option and Shift key and drag a corner to shrink it. In the timeline here, I'm going to shrink this. I'm going to grab the right side and drag it down so it's just about 1 second long. So next I'm going to create a new group. Everything's inside a group. So I have a group here with the MacMost logo that was created automatically. I'm going to make sure I don't have anything selected and I'm going to create a new group so it's at an equal level with this other group. It's not inside of this first group. So now I've got group one, and in group one I'm going to draw a circle. So there's little drawing tools here. I can click it and select circle. I can draw a circle. If I hold down the shift key, it will lock it to be a circle, not an oval. And I'll drop it there. So now I've got group one with a circle in it. With that circle selected, I'm going to go to the inspector here. And I'm going to make sure the fill color is set to white. So if it's not, you can click on it and change the color to white. I'm going to go to Geometry, and here I can change the radius. So I don't want it to be this big circle here. I want it to be a small one. I'm going to change that to 3 to make just a nice little dot there. Then I'm going to go to Properties, and I'm going to reposition it here to the center. I can also drag and drop it just to the center, but I'm going to set it to 0, 0, so it's in the center of the screen. Now with that circle still selected, I'm going to click the Make Particles button. It's also under Object and Make Particles. So now group one has an emitter that's a particle emitter. What does a particle emitter do? Well, let's go and move the timeline forward and we could see what's happening here. It's emitting all these particles. Particle emitters are one of the key ways to create special effects. So the first thing I want to do is instead of having it just emitting particles from a point, I want to change that so it explodes from a point. So I'm going to set the birth rate to 0. In other words, don't keep adding new particles to it. But instead I'm going to set the initial number to an amount. I'm going to keep it at 1000 right now. And notice it's a circle. What's happening is 1000 particles are being born from the center initially and they're expanding out and they're doing it uniformly. So I'm going to change that so that the speed is a little bit faster. I'm going to change it to 1000. And now you can see it's going to move faster here, less in the timeline. And I'm going to give it a speed randomness of 500. What that's going to do is basically say it can be anywhere from 500 to 1500 in terms of the speed of each one of these. So you get a ring of particles exploding from the center. Now I'm going to change the shape of the explosion from a point to an image. When I do that, I get an image source here and I'm going to drag the logo into that image source. So now instead of exploding as a point, it's going to do so in the shape of the logo. I need to change the arrangement to random fill. And now if I view this, you'll see at the beginning come out of the shape of the MacMost logo. You could see this a lot better if you increase the initial number. The amount you use is going to depend on the size of your logo in its general shape. You might be able to use less than 1000. For my logo, you're going to have to use a lot more. I'm going to go to 5000 here, and now I can see how the particles really are kind of clinging at the beginning there to the exact shape of the MacMost logo, and then they explode outward from that. Now these are white particles exploding from a logo that has multiple colors. I can fix that by changing the color mode from original to take image color.
And now the particles will explode with the same color as the logo. So you can see the red particles coming from the M there in the middle and white coming from the outline outside. Now we want this explosion to be a 3D explosion like this is happening in space. So I'm going to check off 3D here. And I'm going to have it explode with a latitude and longitude of 0 and 0. So in other words, coming right at us and exploding 360 degrees, so all around. So now it's basically a space explosion exploding from the middle. Now what I'd like to happen is I like the particles to start off large and get smaller as they fade away. So with emitter selected here, I'm going to go to behaviors and I'm going to add a particles behavior for scale over life. That's going to immediately switch me to the behaviors tab here with that scale over life selected. I don't want it to start at 0 and go to 100. I want it to start at 100 and go to 0. So start off big with big particles and get smaller. So now if I move the timeline here, you can see the particles get tiny and disappear. So now let's cut the time for this explosion down, because you can see if I go out far enough, kind of around here, it's all gone. But the explosion continues here in the timeline. I'm going to select the entire group here and I'm going to hit the O key for out, and it's going to trim off the timeline here. Now if I look here in the timeline, you can see I've got group 1 and I've got this original group here that has the logo. I don't want the logo to be hanging around in the background like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select group 1 and I'm going to position this timeline here just at the point where the logo disappears. And I'm going to move group 1 so it starts at that point. So now you can see by going left and right with the arrow keys, in one frame I've got the logo, and the next frame I've got the beginning of the particle explosion, which is almost a perfect outline of the logo itself. Matter of fact, if I were to go back to the emitter and change the number of particles, the initial number, to something more, then it would almost look exactly like it. So for instance, if I were to change this to 10,000, you could see how it fills out the logo even better. So now I can click here to go back to the beginning, hit play, and see what it looks like. So that looks good. That's what I want. But what if I want that in reverse? One thing I could do is I could just export it as is, and in a lot of things like in iMovie, I could just then reverse the clip. But I could also go ahead and select this group here and then command click to select both these groups here. Then I can go to Object and Group to group them together. So now I have my explosion as a single group. I can go to Object and then make clone layer. So now I have group 2, which is a clone of group 1. I can take the clone layer and move that further along in the timeline. So now I basically have got the explosion one time and then the explosion again. Clone layers though can be reversed. So I can select this clone layer here, and then under Inspector Properties Timing I can show the timing, and here I've got the ability to reverse it. I can't do that with the original. I can only do that with the clone. So if I reverse this, now if I move the playback head here, you can see the second one actually does the entire thing in reverse. And I could deselect everything and then play to get a nice effect there. There's the explosion and there it is in reverse. Now note the speed might be a little off because it's got to process everything in real time. When you go to Share, Export Movie, all that processing will take place as it's building the video clip, and the resulting clip will play at full speed.
Then if you only want to use the implosion, you could just clip to use the second half of the exported video. And that'll work with any graphic you want to put in there.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.